guys, so today's video is going to be a tag that Emily and I made up ourselves, and you can probably tell from the description above, but this is going to be the college tag. So Emily and I are going to two different schools, but both of us are starting as freshmen, obviously.
Yeah.
And we just thought that this would kind of be a cool thing to do, and I've been doing a couple of different college-related videos, so this is just going to be a tag for anyone that went to college or that is starting college or in college right now. Just some little questions, I guess, about the whole experience.
Yeah.
So
we don't really know anything about college because we haven't been there yet, so maybe we'll like do it again in a year and see if our answers are the same or if they change.
It's definitely something that will change like as you go, as you get more used to the whole experience. So with that being said, if you guys want to do this video, make sure that you leave it as a video response below and you give this video a thumbs up, and we're gonna get into the questions. Okay, so question number one is, what was your dream school and where did you end up going to it?
My dream school was FIDM, or the Fashion Institute of Design and Merchandising, in Los Angeles, and I did get accepted as a junior, and I think that is a pretty big deal because most people don't get accepted to schools as a junior. Mostly you'll get accepted as a senior. I didn't end up going because it is on the other side of the country and my mom was not too thrilled.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, my dream school was actually Stanford, and because it was in California and totally out of my league of schools, I didn't even bother applying, so obviously I didn't end up going there. But it was definitely like that holy grail dream school that like I always thought about in the back of my mind, but yeah.
Question number two is, what was your number one thing on your college checklist?
For me, it was like the weather. I applied to a lot of schools that were far north, and like I just dreaded ending up going there because they didn't want like gloomy weather, because I'm so affected by that, and where my sister goes to school, it's like that. So my main goal was to find some place that was pretty sunny, even if it wasn't like beach weather all the time. I just wanted something that would be a happy environment.
Mine was probably if they had my major, because it's not a very broad major. I'm going obviously into fashion, and I just wanted to look at the programs, because a lot of schools do have fashion programs, but it's not as rigorous as I would have wanted it to be. And my school is linked with a really well-known fashion school, so I think that my program is really good and that it's like good for me.
Yeah, hers is obviously a lot more specific. Like someone like me going for English, you pretty much have the same program at any school you go to. So I got to focus on something a little more casual. Question number three, what were or are you most excited for?
I'm probably most excited for meeting people, but I'm also nervous for it because you're basically just starting over. You're like, what if they don't like me? What if I don't have friends? But at the same time, you can meet your best friend, you can meet your future husband or wife, or just people that like you can be with for the rest of your life.
So yeah, it's a whole new world with that.
Yeah, I think that that's what I'm most excited for. And I think also just like being on my own and not having to tell my mom where I'm going, or just to have that freedom. I think that's something that a lot of children don't get, and that, I don't know.
Yeah, for me, it's definitely the freedom aspect of things. One, because I don't really go out that much now. Like, I'm very much a homebody. So I think to kind of be able to take control of what I do on my everyday, like, basis is definitely going to be something that I really enjoy more. And also, like, the flexibility of your schedule in school is always, like, the same thing, 9 to 5. Like, every day waking up at the same time, going to sleep at the same time, having the same classes that give homework every day. Like,
and like being with the same people for the past 12 years.
Yeah, so it's definitely like a whole new experience with everything.
I think everyone that's about to go to college or that is in college can say that they've grown a lot.
Yeah.
And I think I'm also excited for that.
And that's like really eye-opening, I think. What were or are you dreading the most?
Probably the food. My school doesn't really have bad food. I'm just a really, really picky eater. Like, I don't eat that much of, like, different things. I like very bland, boring things, and I just feel like I'm just going to be living on carbs, and I do not want the freshman 15.
Yeah, the freshman 15. I'm so scared of that. But my school has like a lot of healthy options.
So does mine.
Not that I necessarily, yeah, not that I'm going to eat them. But what I'm dreading the most is the bathroom. I'm so OCD.
I'm like dreadful. I'm camps. Like, I'm used
to
that.
Yeah, I can't even share a bathroom with my sisters, so I don't know how I'm supposed to do it with a whole floor of girls. So that's definitely what I'm dreading the most. I'm not like...
Yeah, that's going to be a really big change.
Yeah, I'm not a public facilities person. What are you or were you saddest to leave behind?
Probably my mom. Because like I'm an only child and the nest is empty and I'm out. Yeah, I feel like, I don't know, I just feel bad that she's just gonna be chilling at home while I'm like meeting all these people and she's just still like working. But if not, my mom and like my bed. Like, oh God, I love my bed.
Yeah, for me, it's going to be like my family, like my parents and like my little cousins now, because they're not going to have anyone to hang out with because I'm the last cousin to go to school besides them. And also the food, like I'm so sad to leave behind like my mom's cooking.
Because I don't know what my family.
My mom cooks every night. So like, I don't know what I'm going to do when like I get everything on like a little tray. So
no, we don't cook in my household. Question number 6, did you choose your roommate or did you go random?
Oh, my turn. I actually went random because I talked to some different people about being roommates, but it was so stressful. It's kind of like, this is going to sound weird to say in a video, but it's girl flirting.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah. 100%. So when you're talking to people like on Facebook or like texting them, like, I just feel like there's so much pressure.
You have to like sell yourself to someone and be like, oh, I'm a great person. Like, yeah. You should want to live with me.
And I don't know. I just felt like if I went random, I would like have the school to blame for me hating my roommate. But if I found them on my own and then I ended up hating them, I would just like have to live in my own like depressions.
So. I think at most schools though, you can change after your first year.
Yeah, you can definitely.
So I think that in that case, if you are going random, that you're fine. I actually chose my roommate. There was a Facebook group and she like posted in it and my mom actually found her because she went on my Facebook and was like, oh my God, she sounds just like you. You should message her. And we just instantly clicked. And I'm telling you, it was like when we met each other, it was just like roommates.
Yeah, I think if you find the person like and they're an exact match, then finding a person is definitely a lot more stress-free. But if you're like me and you had to talk to like 5 different girls, you just kind of give up after.
Yeah, and when they're like, oh, I don't want a room, you just feel really like rejected.
Yeah, it's kind of like if a guy like says no to you, like to go on a date or something, like just don't
want
to do
that. But I think also like you don't need your roommate to be your best friend.
Yeah. It's definitely
like if you guys can share and you make compromises, like say one wants to go to sleep early, one wants to go to sleep late, like you make a compromise, I think that is the best for me because you're not spending all your time with them that you can get sick of them.
Yeah, and I think that going into your second or third year, like you can always pick your roommate then.
Yeah.
So if something doesn't work out, like it's not the biggest deal. Question number 7, if you could give one recommendation to someone starting the pre-college process, what would it be? And this is like testing or picking your college or anything really like
that. Well, for testing, I did the ACT. I didn't take the, I mean, I took the SATs, but I didn't send in those scores. Because I think for the ACT, like for me, it was a better test because if you guessed on a question and you got it wrong, you weren't penalized. Like the SAT, you would lose a fourth of a point. But I would say for the whole college process is if you're a junior or even a sophomore, start looking at schools that you might be interested in. If you have the ability to tour them and just see if you have, like, if you want to apply there, if they have extra things. Like, I know FITM, I had to do a project for them, and, like, that took me 2 weeks to do. So just try and do that and try and start as early as you can because your summer going into your senior year.
You want to have fun.
Yeah, you're not going to want to be like, oh, I need to study for this test or I need to work on this essay. Like, you're going to want to go to the beach with your friends or go to the mall or something.
My biggest recommendation, like, for testing is to really take it seriously because I totally didn't. Like, I was always good at school and I was a little cocky, I think, going into the testing process. And, like, as it turned out, I didn't, like, I should have taken the ACT more than the SAT because that's what I was better at, and I think that that's something that every tester should figure out for themselves, which one they should focus on, and I didn't figure that out until too late in the process.
I think the first time you have the ability to take one SAT and one ACT and see which test is better for you, or even get like the big Princeton books and take them at home.
Yeah, and then my other recommendation is, like, it might be a lot more work, but definitely don't count any schools out from like where you want to apply, because I know the school that I am going to, like, I almost didn't even apply there, and it ended up being like where I was gonna go. So okay, so that is it for the college tag. If you guys are going to college and you want to do this video, make sure to leave it as a video response below, and we will talk to you guys later. Bye.